गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी सॉफ्टवेयर टेस्टिंग यूनिट 3 सेशन 1। इन द प्रीवियस टॉपिक वी हैव कंप्लीटेड द यूनिट 2 दैट इज एक्सेप्टेंस टेस्टिंग। इन टुडेज टॉपिक वी विल सी अबाउट परफॉर्मेंस टेस्टिंग और लोड टेस्टिंग। दिस इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज लोड टेस्टिंग। सो वी कैरी आउट दिस टाइप ऑफ टेस्टिंग टू चेक आउट हाउ इज द रिस्पॉन्स टाइम ऑफ अवर सिस्टम एंड हाउ मच स्पीड एंड हाउ प्रॉपरली all applications are operating and how much long time it is waiting for the user to give the response with all the functions. So in this type of performance testing, you are going to compare your product with other competitive product. So when you compare your product with other competitive product, you will understand what your product is missing and how you can make your product better when you compare it with other product. Because in today's generation, there is a lot of competition and you have to give the 100% to your software product, and you need to improve the performance, and you need to make your applications of the software product work better. Because if your software product is slow, then obviously the users who are going to use your software product, if it is too slow, response is not fast and not working properly, then obviously the people are going to visit other website or they're going to go for other software product. The testing performed to evaluate the response time, throughput and utilization of the system to execute its required function in comparison with different versions of the same product or a different competitive product is called performance testing. So the testing performed to evaluate, so as I told you, so this type of testing is conducted to check out the response time of the system, throughput, how much speed the response is coming from the system, how much long time it is waiting for the user to wait for the application to work, and how all the infrastructure of the system is used, that is memory or any network or any operating system or any other type of infrastructure. And to execute its required function in comparison with different versions of the same product or a different competitive product. And also it is like comparing your product with other competitive product or comparing your product with other versions of the product or with the same version of the product. So this all is done in a performance testing. Performance testing is defined as a type of software testing to ensure that software applications will perform well under their expected workload. So first of all, when the increase on the system, when the load on the system increases, how your system is behaving, whether it is performing all the applications correctly or any of the functions are failing. The goal of performance testing is to not find bugs but to eliminate performance bottleneck. So the goal of performance testing is not to find bugs but to check out how is the quality of the performance, and if there are any drawbacks in the quality of the performance, then that can be removed out, that can be found and solved. For example, it is estimated that 40% of online marketing or shopping for consumer goods in the USA happens over a period of November to December. Slowness or lack of response during this period may result in losses due to the tune of several million dollars to organizations. So it is estimated that 40% of online marketing or shopping in the USA during the period of November to December is considered very important, because in USA and all, during November to December, they celebrate the Christmas and all, and lot of online shopping will happen during this. So if your application, your software product or the website is slow during this period, then obviously it is going to affect your business and you may suffer a loss. So during this time, your software should not fail and your software product should be not slow, whether it is a software product or a website or an online product or offline product. It should not perform slow. And response must be fast, because lot of transactions will be happening during this period and your business can gain a lot and your business can make a lot of profit during this. Another example of this performance testing is that you are seeing that when examination results are published on the internet, several hundreds or thousands of people access the educational websites within a short period. If a given website takes a long time to complete the request, or whether if it is taking more time to display the pages, that is result, to display the result of the students, then it may mean a loss of business opportunity and people may try to go to other website. So during when the exam results are out, this period is very important because a heavy load occurs on the educational websites. And during this time, the system, the website should not fail. The response must be fast and it should give the quick result to the students. And if the load occurs on the server, then it may not be able to display any of the result. And it is going to be a loss. And also, the students may not be able to see the results. So, in this internet era, there is an expectation that all applications must run as fast as possible. Because when applications run fast, a system can fulfill the business requirements quickly and put it in a position to expand its business and handle the future need as well. But due to slow performance, a system or product that is not able to service business transactions may suffer from a big loss for the product organization and its customers. So in today's world, in today's generation, the online website, online applications, software products, any software product should give you the response fast because the customer expects the quick response and nobody has that much patience to wait for a long time. So this should be tested. These all points should be tested in a performance testing before delivering the system or before launching the system in the market. Next, we'll see factors that govern performance testing. So these are the factors which will be tested, especially in the performance testing. More focus will be on these factors. First one is throughput. So that is the speed is measured here of your software product for each application, for each function. A product is expected to handle multiple transactions in a given period. The capability of the system or the product in handling multiple transactions is determined by a factor called throughput. So within a given period of time, it should handle more number of transactions. Means your system must be able to perform more number of transactions within a given period of time. So how much speedily it will perform transactions, that much the number of transactions will increase within a less time. So throughput is needed, that is within a less time, more number of transactions must be performed. So that much response must be fast from your system. That is measured here. Next is response time. This can be defined as the delay between the point of request and the first response from the system. So response time we call when first the user makes the request, that time is considered, and the system when it is giving the first response. So this time is calculated when the user request, first request, that time, and when the system is giving the response. So that gap time is calculated and tested. How is the response of the system? Find out the reason for the delay of response time. So if it is giving too much time to give the response from the system, a lot of delay, then find out the reasons why the response is giving slow, why it is not fast. Next is latency. Is a delay caused by the applications like operating system or by the environment, product sharing the network resources, that are calculated separately. So there are also reasons the performance can be slow by the operating system or by the any other softwares or any other reason, or it can be also due to the network or any other resource. So this can be also calculated and find out the reason. Next is tuning, process in which one or more parameters of a product are adjusted upwards or downwards to achieve an improved or specified result without having to touch the code. So tuning means find out when the load increases, means when you scale up some of the parameters of the product, software product, or when you scale down some of the parameters of the product, or when you are doing adjustment upwards or downwards by taking some parameters of the software product, then you can check out, like example, take this only, load only. When you increase the load on a system, when you increase and decrease the load, how your system is behaving in this case. So increasing the load and decreasing, this is one parameter. Like this way you can also take other parameters and you can check out. Benchmarking, performance testing where the product is compared with competitive products are called benchmarking, especially throughput and response time. So when you are comparing your product with other product, especially its throughput and response time is measured with your software. Capacity planning, right kind of or the exercise to find out the resources and configuration is needed to derive the best results from performance testing. So capacity planning is, so whenever you are conducting this performance testing, you need to set up the lab for that. Means you need to gather the proper requirements, resources, you need to set up the configurations like 2 GB RAM. You need first test out in 2 GB RAM, then 4 GB RAM, then use the other configurations. So right kind of resources and configurations need to find out the best result for performance testing. So next point is process for performance testing. So when you want to carry out the performance testing, you need to follow some process steps. So first step is obtain testable requirements. So identify which requirements you want to test, and which especially you select those requirements which are the important part of the software product. Next, create a performance test plan. So to test those requirements, how you are going to do the planning? Okay, what you need to gather and how much resources you need, how much people you need to conduct it, what setup you need to perform, and how many days you need to conduct that, and are you going to use any ready-made tools or schedule? This all comes under this performance test plan. Next, design test cases. So based on the requirement, the main functions of the software product which you identified, design the test cases for that. Especially when you design the test cases for this, and the test cases will be related to the configurations. Okay, first you are going to test with 2 GB and with Pentium 3, and the network bandwidth will be so and so. The next test case will be like you are going to conduct the test with 4 GB with a Pentium 5 and with some other configuration. So like this way the test case design. Next, automate test cases. Okay, now if you are going to use some ready-made tools to perform this performance testing, then especially to perform this performance testing, ready-made tools are used, because to carry out manually, it is going to take a lot of time and you may not be able to complete the testing on time. So if you use automated tools which will give the accurate result within a less time, and where the result will be quick of this automated test is. So mostly most of them prefer the automated test tool to conduct this performance testing. Then find out which type of automated tools you are going to use and how you are going to use them. Next, evaluate entry criteria. So from where you are going to start it and with what input you are going to provide and so on. Then perform and analyze performance test cases. Then identify, and you need to analyze how the test cases are behaving, whatever you design, how it is performing, whether it is according to expected or whether it is failing. So this result you need to analyze and you need to test. Then evaluate exit criteria. So identify the exit criteria of any function. You should identify your system should support only this much load, and when the load on the system increases this much, this is the end criteria. Your system may chance there are chances of failing. So this must be decided. So designing the test cases is very important here, because in the test cases you are going to specify with how much load you are going to test. First you are going to test with the 20,000 load, and to increase the 20,000, how you are going to increase the load? Are you going to increase number of transactions, or are you going to increase login times, or are you going to increase the data in the database? So these you are going to specify in the test case. So first you are going to test with 20,000 people, users, then you are going to test with 22,000, then you are going to test with 25,000 load. So this you are going to specify in the test cases, and then when you start testing it, then one by one test cases you are going to test and you are going to analyze the result. So this is the diagram of the process of performance testing. So obtain major testable requirements, your first step. Then create a performance test plan. Third step, design test cases. Then fourth step, are you going to use automated tools to perform those? Then identify, evaluate, entry criteria. So these are the four basic steps you need to first conduct. Then after fixing this, then you can go for this, evaluate entry criteria, perform and analyze test cases, then evaluate exit criteria. So this all comes under the planning before beginning the performance testing, and this is after performance testing. You are going to analyze the result and all, what improvements you need to do. This is before conducting the test, and that is after conducting the test. So in the next class, we'll see some other topic of the performance testing. Thank you.